Hi, my name is Tim Greten. I'm an investigator at the Center for Cancer Research at the National Cancer Institute. Together with Firzi Kurangi, I'm senior author on a publication that is appearing in the Journal of Clinical Investigation called Peptides Released by Necrotic Cells Controlled CD8-Positive T-Cell Priming. The first author of this publication is a very talented postdoc named Jabagam Rikelashvili. Our lab has been interested in the role of tumor cell death for a number of years in order to understand basic immunology questions, but also to improve future anti-cancer treatments. Necrotic tumor cell death has actually tremendously different effects on anti-tumor responses, as we've already shown many years ago. As you can see, we have set up a very simple method initially to induce necrotic cells or apoptotic cells by inducing irradiation. If we vaccinate mice, as you can see here, there's a tremendous difference, and a clear difference, as you can see, that mice vaccinated with irradiated tumor cells are clearly protected from mice, whereas all mice that are vaccinated with the necrotic cells develop tumors. In order to understand the basic immunological question, we used the B78H1 tumor cell, which is an MHC class 1 melanoma. We transduce these cells with ovalbumin, and we induce tumor cell death by freeze-thawing the cells. We use this tumor cell lysate to pulse dendritic cells, and 10 days later, we challenged mice. As you can see, there was absolutely no protection when we used a dendritic cell pulsed with this tumor lysate. However, if we did actually a very simple trick, and we briefly heated the tumor cell lysate prior to pulsing it onto dendritic cell, we got a significant tumor reduction. This was not only the case in terms of survival, but we could also show, as you can see here, an induction of a CD8 T cell lysis with the heated tumor cell lysate. Based on this observation, we formulated the following hypothesis. There must be a factor in the tumor cell lysate which is preventing the induction of an anti-tumor immune response. We named this factor Veto factor. And whenever the Veto factor is present, we suggest that there will be no T cell activation. However, if with whatever mechanism I have already shown you, if we heat, for instance, the tumor cell lysate, we destroy this Veto factor, we will see a T cell activation. We set up an in vitro system, and through a multi-step biochemical approach, we identified actually two proteins which were responsible and worked as a Veto factor, thymid oligopeptidase 1 and dipeptidase 2. As you can see on this slide, TOP knockdown significantly increased the immune response, not only in response when we use when we use necrotic cells, but also with irradiated tumor cells. This whole mechanism was proteasome dependent and was not only an observation that we could make in vitro, but we also observed the same if we actually looked for the T cell response in vivo. So the proposed mechanism of immune responses generated during sterile necrotic cell death and the control of cross-priming by cellular peptides is shown here. Whenever a tumor cell dies, and this can be through freeze-thaw in a very artificial system, but it can also be through gamma irradiation, there is antigens being released. Dependent on the proteasome which has to be present, these antigens are processed into oligopeptides. Now, if the Veto factor, and we identified as Veto factor oligopeptidases, are present, the active Veto factor is actually digesting these peptides, so they are no longer present, and there is no way for the T cell to be primed. If, however, we either genetically knock down the Veto factor, or we just heat the protein and destroy its function, we will induce cross-priming. Now, the relevant question is, obviously, this was a very basic system. How does this actually apply in vivo? So we developed a tumor model where we actually induced the tumors in vivo. We grew them until they are 5 to 8 millimeters in size, irradiated the mice, and we used tumors which expressed the Veto factor or where the Veto factor TOP1 was actually knocked down. And as you can see, there was a significant difference in the antigen-specific T cell response. All those mice that grew a tumor where we had the TOP knockdown showed a much higher lysis, both in the draining lymph node as well as in the spleen, than those where we used the control tumor cell. In summary, our data describes another mechanism how tumor cell death may affect anti-tumor immune responses. This has several implications both for basic immunology as well as potential treatments in cancer immunology. We have identified a novel mechanism by which antigens are actually digested upon tumor cell death, and this will affect anti-tumor immune responses. The presence of Veto factor is an important mechanism by which dying tumor cells can evade anti-tumor immune responses. We have identified that oligopeptides rather than whole antigens are actually the source of antigen for cross-priming, while our data does not provide clear evidence yet whether these antigens are directly presented by dendritic cells or whether there is a mechanism, or whether there is a processing-dependent mechanism involved. Further on, our data has clear clinical implication whenever we use tumor cell lysates to pulse onto dendritic cells. There are currently a number of clinical trials where tumor cell lysates are used as the antigen source, and our data suggest that a careful preparation of these tumor cell lysates, which will include a destruction of oligopeptides, will ultimately lead to more potent anti-tumor immune responses and better outcome. Most importantly, our in vivo data suggest that whenever we irradiate tumor cells, blockade of oligopeptides may have significant effects, not only on the direct effect of the radiation-induced tumor cell death, but also on the induction of anti-tumor immunity. By inducing a more potent anti-tumor immunity, in addition to the radiation-induced effect, we will actually induce a much stronger anti-tumor effect and make our treatments more effective.